There he is. The man, the myth. Hello.
That's what I did.
What?
Thanks to you calling me, I left this on the plane. That would have been my passport, my way home, my iPad, my life.
You serious?
G99 out the Firth Park Tunnel.
Gogsy here, and welcome to episode 132 of Around the Grounds. And there's no better way to welcome back competitive football than saying you've reached 3,000 subscribers. Thank you very much, guys. Much appreciated. I'll do a proper video on it later on. But we've been joined by Mark for his first ever Scottish game today. Won the well. So we're going to get the 10:04 train. And we're basically just going to go straight to Glasgow, and we'll be meeting a few others on the way. I'm on the way out. So here we are, Hampden, starting and finishing our season at Hampden.
I need bother.
Mark, what's the score going to be?
I have no clue because I'm Welsh. But I am going to go for a nice 2-2 draw.
Alright, okay. Fresh Quandro, what's the score going to be?
Okay, as long as Motherwell wins, you know.
Oh, yes.
But my honestly record is not good.
No, it's terrible, isn't it? So, what's the score going to be?
Take 1-0
Motherwell. 1-0 Motherwell. Date 1, what's the score going to be?
I'm going to go for a solid 3-0 Motherwell. Gail Bigger Man scoring the goal.
Aye. Ryan, what's the score going to be? 2-0. Ryan, Rudy, sorry.
2-1.
You say that and then you know what's going to happen.
They'll score first.
They'll go 1-0. I'm going to go for a 3-0 win as well. Motherwell. Mark!
Sorry!
Out! Fuck off!
Fuck off! He's away!
He parried it onto a bar and then he just jumped into it.
Come on, that's terrible, Ben. At least he caught it that time.
That time 1-0.
I don't actually know what to say. We've only had one shot on target.
All I'm saying is it's not been great. Literally, the long ball game is not working as per usual. And my lord, I'm trying to check out. Maybe the 2 touch at all. And maybe they'll win it. It's 21. But these guys, I can't fault them. They're doing very well on counter. And they look like they are hot and ready to get a ball. And for the world, if they keep letting their chances slip, you can't fault Queen's Park get a ball.
No. I couldn't have put it any better myself. Thank you, man.
No problem.
Please,
can that count?
Just copy Lee Griffiths, mate. Copy Lee Griffiths.
Right, replicate the falling down the stairs.
This
beach.
Would be the first Mullen set piece free kick since.
No, McFadden scored one, hasn't he?
Tanner fancied it. Molt does as well.
Nah, Molt's on it.
Molt's taken it. Starting and finishing your season with a win at Hampden.
God, fucking hope so.
Called it out of your first.
Yeah, like one as well.
Don't know about 5-1, but
Depends on the opposition.
On the well. So, we are going back home on the train now. Still got Fraser.
Well, you've got to take the ferry then.
No, the ferry, aye. But we're going via Coral because my coupon came in.
So did the groups.
Exactly, that's great.
Did it, and do you know whose fault it is? Manparade.
Yes, Mark would like to actively dislike Manparade now.
Because Partick Thistle lost to Livingston. Or lost in penalties. But yeah, Morton, Dundee United, Dunfermline, Falkirk, Hibs and Motherwell all came through. Woohey!
You want
I can't believe I bet Motherwell.
You won.
What?
You won.
Oh yeah, let's see what yours was.
Who chose Hamilton? Who chose Morton? I can't remember.
Who chose Hamilton?
I don't even know, but the group won £255.
Yes! But anyway.
Yeah, Coral's down there.
Coral! I breathe your love. And we are back in...
We are!
Cooper! What a day it's been!
This is Lidl over there?
Yes, that's Lidl.
Wow!
Yeah! Yeah!
Can I give my thoughts on the day?
Yeah, what would you like to add to this video?
Before we go on to our, well, Gordon...
Punditry!
What do you think of the day? I would just like to say that today was a brilliant day. Like,
it was fucking great.
And it's far from over, to be honest.
Yeah.
Like, because we're still working home.
Yeah.
And
it's
just been
fantastic.
It's actually been like a proper like full day out.
Oh.
And it's been, man, like, I'd just like to say as well, I don't think I said this in my vlog, so sorry lads, but I'd love to say thank you to Fraser, Declan, Ryan, and Rory.
Yes.
Is that how you say it?
That's how you say Rory.
For making this day even better.
Aye.
Because the banter was brilliant.
It was a good banter, wasn't it?
Yeah, cheers lads.
It was a really good day and I can't wait for the next trip.
As you were.
MP, yes. Kiss. And also I won £22 from the bookies. I still can't believe it. That's
and
me got my first coupon done. Partick let Mark down, but that's Manpete's fault, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. But I wouldn't rub it in too much because I've seen Motherwell beat Livingston twice.
Right, so overall, Mark, what did you think of the game?
Right, so obviously this view is going to be coming from an English Football League fan. Not an English Premier League. Oi, calm down. From my view, as it was like my first game, a lot of it was long ball, like in the first half especially.
That's basically Scottish football.
I know, but first half was pretty much long ball game.
Yeah.
And it never works. And
no, it never does.
Literally, every time you're on the attack, you look like the stronger team, except for the fact that whenever you're on the attack with the long ball, if Queen's Park intercept, they have a counter-attack,
yeah.
And their counter-attack was a dangerous one.
Yeah, it was.
It was normally a dangerous one. And obviously, they didn't score off the counter-attack.
There was a bit of complacency in the first half as well, I think.
Yeah, I think you went into that game and you were like, right, Queen's Park, we're in the Premiership, we're there, well,
League One,
and you're like, right, we can sort this. And it just didn't work in the first half, and then you got a wake-up call.
When they scored, yeah.
I think, yeah. And... But I would like to say that Ryan Bowman scored first, didn't he?
No, it was Cadden scored.
That's right.
Bowman was a sub.
Sorry guys if I get some of the names wrong about here.
Yeah, one job.
It was a good finish, I would say.
Oh aye. It was a great layoff from Alex Fisher.
It was
Fisher.
A bit of a bad play.
The only time Alex Fisher did something right the whole last 2 weeks.
I'm sorry, but Alex Fisher, I'm sorry if you're watching this, I really am.
He might be. Can do. He needs to work.
He needs to work on.
There's like, a lot of room for improvement.
To stop.
But second half, I thought we were, of course, a better team.
You were.
We. I think if we play like that more often, we'll win games more comfortably. I mean, we were very shaky, of course, in the first half, but second half, as soon as we got the second goal, I thought, right, we're going to go on and win 4-5-1, and we did. But Ryan Bowman was class when he came on.
Ryan Bowman, like, fair play to. You could be watching this, couldn't you?
You never know.
Right,
last two times he's spoken to me, he said, Chris, that's one big camera.
Ryan Bowman, if you're watching this, I would like to say, firstly, at the end of your contract, please come to Newport. Secondly, that was a brilliant play from him.
The first goal, his touch was phenomenal to get it in.
I think the second goal of the game, which is Craig Tanner's.
Craig Tanner, Love Craig Tanner.
Ex-Plymouth, I'm not happy. That was such a good piece of play by Motherwell. And in a way, it was kind of against the run of play. No one really expected that to happen.
No one expected
the way it happened, it was just.
Because Richard Tate made the tackle in the box, and then. Tanner took it off him.
And the quick
touch football, it was supreme.
But you didn't see that consistently. But what I'm always kind of disappointed with, like Elliot Freer, I know he's a brilliant player.
I could tell.
He's sharp.
In the second half, Queen's Park always had two men on him.
Because what was happening was, if it was on the other side of the field, they would always work it to get to Elliot Freer.
Yeah.
And Queen's Park, cleverly, read that quite well, but fair play to him, he dealt with it and got the crosses in, but the touches were quite weak in the box, but I would have liked to see him take on the defenders more.
Yeah, that's why I reckon
he'd be dangerous in the box alone.
In the last few months of last season, what he did best was get to the byline and cut back.
Yeah, like I would love to see him just go through him. Like, because he can go through, you can tell he could go through. He's got.
Yeah.
Like, I'd say he's got the pace and physicality. Well, he's getting there with physicality.
Yes.
He could do a lot more
But
with the attack, but he did his job.
He did his job, yeah.
It's just a shame that not all the touches were supreme. Because if they were, you would have been winning that game a lot more.
But anyway, we won 5-1 and it's all smiles. So tomorrow, it's. Wraith Rovers versus Dundee.
Oh.
Looking forward to it.
I thought I was missing out on coverage.
But anyway guys, I hope you enjoyed. Please leave a like down below if you want more of this jazzy content. Subscribe to Mark, his link's in the description. And yeah, I'll see you later guys. Take care.
Bye.